In this screencast, we'll learn three different methods for solving reaction problems. So here's a simple example that we'll use to demonstrate all three methods. So let's consider a reaction such that A plus 2B goes to C. So here's our reactor, and we have 10 moles of A and 30 moles of B that enter the reactor. And we also know that the fractional conversion of A is equal to 0.9. And what we want to do is to find the number of moles of each component in the product stream. So that would be NA, NB, and NC. So the three methods that we're going to use to solve for the products are A, molecular species balances, extent of reaction, and finally, atomic species balances. So all of these use the general material or mass balance that says the mass in minus the mass out plus the mass generated minus the mass consumed is equal to the accumulation. And since we're going to consider this a steady state process, this term is going to be equal to zero. So let's write this in terms of N out, since that's what we're looking for. So N out of any species is equal to the amount in plus the amount generated minus the amount that is consumed. So we're going to begin with the molecular species balance. According to the problem statement, A and B go into the reactor. Some of both of them are consumed, C is generated, and A, B, and C come out of the reactor. So let's see how we write that out in terms of each species. So because this is equal to zero, we can just write it exactly like this. So the number of moles of A that are coming out is equal to the number of moles of A coming in. Now there's no A that's generated, but there is an amount that's consumed. Now we know from our picture, we know the number of moles of A that comes in, so let's put it here. Now we're going to do the same thing for B. The number of moles of B is equal to, now we have the 30 moles of B that come in, nothing is generated, and then this is minus the B that's consumed. And finally, when we look at C, we find that C, the number of moles of C coming out is equal to, we have nothing of C that comes in, but we do have the amount of C that's generated. So first let's use our fractional conversion of A. So our fractional conversion of A says that the number of moles of A in minus the number of moles of A out divided by the number of moles of A in is going to be equal to 0.9. So we know that this is equal to 10, as is this. And so now we're able to figure out the numbers of moles of A out. And that's going to be equal to 1. And then when we put that into this equation, so I'm saying that NA and NA out are the same, now we know that the number of moles of A that are consumed is equal to 9 moles. Now we're going to use the stoichiometry of the reaction with our other balances to solve for NB and NC. So the number of moles of B that are coming out is equal to 30 plus 0. And now what we do is we use the stoichiometry. So this is minus, so we have 2 moles of B that are consumed for every 1 mole of A that's consumed. And again, we'll go back to the reaction up here that says A plus 2b goes to c. We multiply that by the number of moles of A consumed, which is 9 moles. And so we end up with that n sub b is equal to 12 moles. So to solve for n sub c, this is equal to just what is generated, and there is 1 mole of C generated for every 1 mole of A that is consumed. And there are 9 moles of A that are consumed. Therefore, N sub C is equal to 9 moles. So this is what's known as the molecular species balances. It's easiest to do this for a single reaction. Next, we're going to use what's called the extent of reaction. So here we're going to use the expression that the number of moles of species I that's out, comes out, is equal to the number of moles of species I that come in plus or minus the stoichiometric coefficient of I times what's known as our extent of reaction, which we have called squiggle before. So if you're generating a product, then this is going to be positive. If you're consuming a reactant, then this is going to be negative. So let's see how this works. We're going to write an extent of reaction again for each one of our species. So Na out, and I'm going to, or we can just call that Na, is equal to Na in, but because this is a reactant, this is minus, the stoichiometric coefficient is 1, and this is our squiggle. So we know from above, from the problem statement, that our Na out is equal to 1 mole. Our Na in is equal to 10 moles, so that allows us to solve for our squiggle, which is equal to 9 moles. Now we're going to do B. So our NB out is equal to our NB in, which we know is 30 moles. And again, it's being consumed. So it's minus. Now here, the stoichiometric coefficient, and I'm going to write this again here, is 2. So this is minus 2 times squiggle, which is 9 moles. So our NB out is going to be equal to 12 moles. And finally, our NC out. Now we have nothing that's coming in. It's positive because we're generating. And this is just equal to squiggle, which is equal to 9 moles. And so if you compare this to the numbers that we got above, you'll see that we have the exact same numbers. So the last method we're going to use is atomic species balances. And here, all we're interested in are the particular atoms. And since atoms are neither generated nor consumed, the balance is actually just going to be in equals out. And so what that means is the number of, for example, carbon atoms in has to equal the number of carbon atoms out. Here, because it is an atomic species balance, we're still going to use that A plus 2B goes to C. So here we're going to have to actually use species. So our reaction is going to be carbon monoxide plus 2 hydrogen gas is equal to methanol. And so let's draw a picture of our reactor. And often what I'll do is I'll write the reaction inside the reactor. And let's see what comes in and comes out. Again, we're going to use the same information that has been given to us before. So we know that the number of moles of carbon monoxide coming in is equal to 10 moles. We know that the number of moles of H2 coming in is equal to 30 moles. We know from the fractional conversion that the number of moles of CO coming out is equal to 1 mole. And so now what we're interested in is how much H2 comes out and how much methanol comes out. And so if we write our balances, we write them in terms of atoms. So let's start with carbon. So the number of moles of carbon monoxide coming in, and we know that there's one carbon atom for every 1 mole of CO, and this is going to be equal to the number of moles of carbon monoxide coming out, and again, one carbon atom in for each carbon monoxide atom. But you have to look at every single product and see if they have carbons or not. And you'll see that our NCH3OH also has carbon in it. And so there's one carbon for every 1 mole of CH3OH. Now we're going to do a hydrogen balance. So the number of moles of H2 coming in. Now here, there are two hydrogens for every 1 H2. And this is going to be equal to the number of moles of H2 that come out. And again, there are two hydrogens for every 1 mole of H2. And then we have hydrogens in our methanol. So we have our N of our methanol coming out. And if you note, there are four hydrogens for every mole of CH3OH. And finally, we do our oxygen balance. And so coming in, the only oxygen is in the carbon monoxide. So there's one oxygen for every CO coming in. And again, coming out, there's one oxygen for every 1 CO, plus our methanol coming out, and there's one oxygen for every methanol coming out. So here we have three equations, but we only have here two unknowns. And so this looks like it's overspecified. But if you look at the carbon balance and the oxygen balance, you see they are exactly the same. So they are not independent, so we don't need both of them, and we can get rid of the oxygen balance. So let's start with our carbon balance. So NCON is equal to 10 moles, and then that's just multiplied by 1. And then the number of moles of carbon monoxide out is equal to 1 mole plus, and now here's our methanol that's out. So from that, we're able to solve for the NCH3OH coming out, which is equal to 9 moles. Now let's do the hydrogen balance. So we know that there are 30 moles coming in. However, because it's a hydrogen balance, not an H2 balance, we have to multiply this by 2. And this is equal to the number of moles of the H2 coming out. But again, we multiply this by 2 plus our 9 moles, which is the number of moles of methanol coming out, times 4. And when we calculate NH2, we find that that's equal to 12 moles. Again, it's the same numbers that we got before. The thing to be very careful of here are these ratios of atoms to species. So which one do you use? My advice to you is, unless told differently, use the method that is most comfortable for you. I tend to use the atomic species balance if I have multiple reactions, because if you notice, we never use the stoichiometry of the reaction at all. I we'll use the extent of reaction or atomic species balances for single reactions, but it's up to you, whatever you like.